Hello friends, welcome to the video lecture series on digital image processing. I am Dr. Alpesh Dafda, and in this 10th video class of DIP, we will study piecewise linear transformation function contrast stretching and its implementation in MATLAB. So in the previous video class, we have studied different linear transformation functions such as image negative, log transformation and power law or gamma transformation, which were linear transformation. And here our approach will be different. Here we will be learning piecewise linear transformation. So as the name suggests, this piecewise linear transformation is linear in different pieces or different parts, as we will just see. So the main advantage of this piecewise linear transformation functions is that the form of function can be arbitrarily complex. And in fact, many practical implementations can be formulated only as piecewise linear functions. And the main disadvantage of this piecewise linear function is that their specification requires considerably more user input. So we have already studied contrast stretching in previous video class, but that contrast stretching was a linear function. Here we will be studying piecewise linear contrast stretching transformation. So let us start. So piecewise linear transformation function is a type of gray level transformation that is used for image enhancement. We are studying different intensity level transformation functions in the spatial domain. It is a spatial domain method. It is used for manipulation of an image so that the result is more suitable than the original for specific applications. So some commonly used piecewise linear transformation functions are contrast stretching, intensity level slicing and bit plane slicing. We will be studying contrast stretching in this video class. So very first question that comes in mind is, what is contrast? So contrast is the difference between the highest gray level and the lowest gray level in an image. See, many times we obtain low contrast images due to poor illumination or due to wrong setting of the lens aperture. And the idea behind the contrast stretching is to increase the contrast of the images by making the dark portions more dark and brighter portion more brighter. And contrast stretching will expand the range of intensity levels in an image so that it spans the full intensity range of display devices. So the function is like this for contrast stretching. So from this function, you can see that there can be three different combinations of R1, S1 and R2, S2. See, when R1 is equal to S1 and R2 is equal to S2, it will become a linear transformation function or identity transformation function like this. So this is your first combination. The second combination can be R1 is equal to R2. R1 and R2 both are same. That means this will be your R2, or here will be your R2, and S1 is equal to 0. S1 is equal to 0 and S2 is equal to L minus 1. That is 255. Okay. So R1 and R2 both are same, and S1 is equal to 0 and S2 is equal to L minus 1, like this. So this we have already studied in previous video class. This function is a thresholding function that will make the image binary, right? The third possibility which is there is different intermediate values of R1 and S1, and this will produce different values of gray. So this is the third combination which is shown over here. So normally R1 is less than or equal to R2 and S1 is less than or equal to S2. So say we want to implement this transformation function for contrast stretching. So for this transformation function, the output S will be given by the equation S is equal to S max minus S minimum upon R max minus R minimum into R minus R minimum plus S minimum. Here S maximum minus S minimum upon R maximum minus R minimum is nothing but the slope of the graph. So this slope of the graph is, say, L for the first piece of the function, M for the second piece of the function and N for the third piece of the function, and output S is given by slope into R for R between 0 to A, where A is your lower threshold and B is your upper threshold. So here A is our lower threshold and B is our upper threshold. So output in between 0 to A or lower threshold will be given by slope into R. From this equation you can see this is our slope, and R minus R minimum. What is R minimum? R minimum is 0 over here, so this will become 0, and of course S minimum is also 0, so S minimum will also be equal to 0. That means your output equation will become slope, that is L into R. So for this particular graph, we have chosen the slope of 0.5 for L and n both. And for the second portion, we have chosen the slope of 2. Okay, remember this A is your lower threshold and this B is your upper threshold. So for this second part, the output will be given by S is equal to slope. Here our slope is 2. So 2 into R minus R minimum. R minus R minimum. What is R minimum? R minimum is the lower threshold, LT. So here we will write LT when we implement it in MATLAB, plus of S minimum, and S minimum over here is given by V. So you can see that the value of this V is equal to 0.5 into lower threshold. It is 0.5 times the lower threshold value. And for the third part of my transformation function, the equation will be given by slope, that is equal to 0.5 into R minus R minimum. R minus R minimum here is upper threshold, plus of S minimum, and S minimum over here is W, which will be addition of this part W to V as well as V to 0. Okay, so it is V to 0 is given by 0.5 into a lower threshold. W to V is twice of upper threshold minus lower threshold. So this is how you get different values of output for different pieces of the transformation function. Input image, which is a very low contrast image. When you apply this transformation function of contrast stretching, you will get a very good high contrast image like this. So if you apply the thresholding function like this, the image will become a binary image like this, which will be having only black and white values. When you implement such contrast stretching function in MATLAB, you will get a good high contrast image like this. So let us implement this in MATLAB. So this program shows contrast stretching using piecewise linear transformation function. The slope we are choosing are 0.5, 2 and 0.5 as we have just studied. Initially I will be reading an image which is a color image and converting that color image into grayscale image by using RGB to gray command. And as I'll be applying some arithmetic operation on the image, I'll be converting the image into IM to double of the original image. So why I'm doing this? Because I'll be adding the intensity levels to the image so that the image becomes more brighter. So what I'll be doing, I'll be multiplying the intensities of each and every pixel of the original image by 2 and dividing it by the maximum value of I, that is 255. Why I'm doing this? I am doing this so that the image becomes more brighter, or low contrast image you can say. And then my output function image stretch, I'll be assigning 0 value and I'll be overwriting these 0 values. Initially I will be finding out the size of the image and storing into rows and columns. The upper threshold and the lower threshold values which I'm giving in this particular program are fixed as 100 and 150. And then again, like the previous lecture, I'm running a for loop for rows and columns. If the input is less than or equal to the lower threshold value, then I am assigning output is equal to 0.5 into input for the first part of the linear transformation function. Else if it is less than or equal to upper threshold, then it is twice into input minus lower threshold, plus of 0.5 into lower threshold, as we have just seen in the transformation function. And for the third part of the transformation function, my slope is 0.5 and the complete equation will be like this: 0.5 into input minus of upper threshold, plus of 0.5 into lower threshold, plus of twice into upper threshold minus lower threshold. So I'll be ending my if else loop and for loops. And for plotting the transformation function, I'll be taking other constant which is equal to dd, and I'll be forming a transformation function graph. From 1 to 100, it will be given by 0.5 of 0 to 99, the first 100 values. From 100 to 150, I'll be again using the same, twice of 100 to 149 minus 100, plus of 0.5 into 100. And from 151 to 256, I'm using again the same equation that we have used here for forming the transformation function. And then I will be plotting my transformation function and giving it different labels. So let us run this program and see the output. So you can see here my original image has become a much brighter image as I have multiplied each and every intensity value by 2. So this image has become a washed out or a very bright image and a low contrast image. And after applying the contrast stretching function, I get a high contrast image like this. You can see here, you cannot see the display board, which you can see here properly, as well as you can also not see the dark and white portion, the shadows over here, which you can see properly over here. And this whole image has become a high contrast image. And the transformation function for this image is plotted like this. And of course, as we have chosen the values between 100 to 150, the upper and the lower threshold. So from 0 to 100, the slope is 0.5. From 100 to 150, it is 2. And then again, it is 0.5. So you can even perform the same program using the inbuilt image of MATLAB, that is cameraman. So I will disable this also, because my original image is a color image and cameraman is a black and white image. And then I can run the program and see the output. Let us run it. So you can see here, I have made the cameraman image more brighter or a washed out type look. And after contrast stretching, I obtain a high contrast image like this. So that is all for this video class. In the next video class, we'll be studying one other piecewise linear transformation function, that is intensity level slicing or gray level slicing. Thank you very much.